Stories of the Companions, Chapter 11K. Abdullah ibn Ubay disgraces his munafiqeen father. During the famous campaign at Banu al-Musgalik in the fifth year al-Hijri, a muhajir had an argument with an Ansari over some trifling matter. Each of them called his own people for help, and there was a serious danger of a fight among the two groups of Muslimin, but through the efforts of some sane people, this was averted. I think it was some sober people. Abdullah ibn Ubayy was the leader of the Munafiqeen. He was a very bitter enemy of Islam. As he posed to be a Muslim, he was treated as such by other Muslimin. When he came to know of this incident, he used some insolent words for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Exploiting the situation, addressed his people thus, "All this is the outcome of the seed that you people have sown with your own hands. You provided refuge to these strangers in your town and shared the wealth equally with them. If you withdraw your help from them, they will be obliged to go back." Muhajirin means the immigrants. He further said, "By law, on return to Medina, we, the respected people, shall drive out these mean people from there." Zayd ibn Arqam radiallahu anhu, an Ansari boy, was listening to him. He could not tolerate these words, and at once retorted by saying to him, "By law, you yourself are wretched. Even your own people look down upon you, and nobody will support you. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is most honored. He is exalted by Al-Rahman, you know, God the most merciful, and revered by his followers." Abdullah ibn Ubay said, "All right, do not mention it to anybody. It was only a jest. I was not serious in what I said." Zayd radiallahu anhu, however, went straight to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and told him what the munafiq had said. Umar radiallahu anhu sought Rasulullah's permission to kill Abdullah ibn Ubay, but Rasulullah refused. When Abdullah ibn Ubay learnt that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had received the report about his insolent talk, he came to him and swore by Allah, saying, "I never said such a thing. Zayd is a liar. He has given you a false report." A few of the Ansar were also sitting with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They also pleaded his case, saying, "O Rasulullah, he is the chief of his clan and is an important man. His statement is more reliable than that reported by a mere boy. It is just possible that Zayd might have misheard or misunderstood him." Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam accepted his statement and took no action against him. When Zayd radiallahu anhu came to know that the munafiq had succeeded in beguiling Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam through false oaths, he would not come out for shame of being considered a liar by the people. He would not even go to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At last, Allah revealed Surah Al-Munafiqun, 63, in which the report of Zayd was confirmed and the munafiq was exposed. After this, all the people began to honor Zayd and look down upon the munafiq. Now, the munafiq had a son. His name was also Abdullah and was a very sincere Muslim. When the Mujahideen were about to reach Medina, he drew out a sword and stood outside the town. In a challenging tone, he said to his munafiq father, "I will not allow you to enter Medina until you admit with your own tongue that it is you who are mean, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is most exalted." This surprised him very much, as the son had always been very respectful to him. But now he is prepared to kill him, his own father, for the honor of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The munafiq had to declare, "By law I am mean, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is most exalted." He was then allowed to enter the town. And it wasn't that he was believed over the son. It's just that it was a testimony versus a testimony, and, you know, you can't punish people if that's all you have. Well, I mean, you can, but it's not right. And, but, yeah, those people who said, well, it's an important person, well, that's not why you believe or disbelieve. And politically, that's, yeah, people do that a lot when a politician or a celebrity or something is accused of something. It's like, they're not any less likely to do something because they're, you know, because it's a person of position saying such things.